Question: should we start panicking over the prices at the grocery store? Back in a minute, we'll talk about this. Hey, good morning, good morning. This is Jan from New York City. My channel name is Jan from New York City. Saves money, and I truly love helping people to keep some more of their hard-earned money. And even my own money, I want to keep some more of. Just saying. You know, this morning, I was straightening up my living room. You know how, like, you play the TV, and sometimes you put on the news. This is just for an example. Keep the news on in the background, multitask, do a few things at the same time. So in the background, I had the news on, you know, one of those all-day news type stations that actually originates from here in New York City. And by the way, a little bit of a trivia note, I actually used to work in that exact building where this particular news place broadcast from. But there was no broadcasting at that time. I'm talking about many, 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 many moons ago. It was like right opposite Radio City Music Hall. Beautiful building, beautiful place to work in Midtown. Anyway, aside from that, there was a gentleman that, you know, they come on every morning, a little bit of a panel there, and going over the news. And, you know, like I said, I'm straightening up nonchalantly, taking my little sips of coffee. Of course, after listening to my replay of my own show. But that's besides the point. And one, they were talking about how prices have really, let's just say, have taken a change. Now, the question begs, should we, I hate to use the word panic over it. No, we shouldn't panic over something like that, because the great news about being frugal, if you live a frugal lifestyle, you already know the methods. It's all about method. The methods that frugal people live as a lifestyle, for example, were very excellent 10 years ago and 15 years ago and probably 10 years from now. It's really about method. But there was a point that actually kind of made me chuckle. So one of the gentlemen on the show that anchors the show said that recently he was shopping with his wife. I don't know where, but my guess is in the New York area, because if he goes to a New York broadcasting studio on a daily basis, I'm going to assume that he probably lives somewhere in the tri-state area. Where does he live? I have no clue. But he went to a grocery store with his wife, and much to his shock, horror, and chagrin, this is a well-versed news person who hears stories every single day. He couldn't believe what he saw for the price of a bottle of, get a load of this. Are you sitting or standing? A bottle of ketchup, $8. What? I wish I had my sound effects machine with me, because I'd be playing that sad drum that goes boom. Or put the gong on, you know, that sound. But it's not funny. I mean, you know, it sounds humorous. I don't know about you, but I do like ketchup. I'm not going to spend $8. The problem, though, is that in my walking around and cleaning up, and no one did mention the size of the bottle. No one did mention the unit price, the ounces. No one mentioned if it was a name brand. I highly doubt that it was a grocery store label brand. I would assume it would be way cheaper than that. So it all depends on coping mechanisms. How many of you out there really love ketchup? And honestly, I can't believe I'm taking the time to talk about this, but this is real life. I enjoy a little ketchup on my hamburger. I know Steve Young is not a fan of ketchup from my memory, if memory serves me right, he's not a fan of ketchup. So Steve Young, 74, this doesn't affect you too much. But yeah, so what do you do as a ketchup alternative? Would you still buy it? Would you just scout around for the least expensive bottle? How do you handle, this is a good question for the comment section below. How do you handle if you really like something, your family enjoys it, but at the moment in time, hopefully that'll change and get better one day. But at this moment in time, we're just using this as the example. But the gentleman saw an $8 bottle of ketchup. I don't know the size. If it's, you know, like a decent size, then maybe it works out. And if your family uses it a lot and you don't like buy it all the time type, I don't know. I don't know what to say on it. What would you do? Would you forego that $8 bottle of ketchup? Would you create an alternative to ketchup? Or would you use less of? Now, here's a concept that a lot of people in the frugal community, let me just grab a sip of my coffee. By the way, if you spend more than a dollar for a cup of coffee, you spent way too much. Let me take a sip of my 15-cent cup of Joe. It's nice and hot. Hang on. And just knowing I only spent 15 cents on it makes it taste that much better. You know what I mean? All right. So since we have these good coping skills, you know, and you know, anyone that is frugal, living the frugal lifestyle, here's what I personally would do. Number one, I would look all around to find, to see if I could get a better price. And when I find that item, see, this is where stockpile comes in handy. You are ahead of the game. Isn't it a lot simpler to just walk to your pantry and find a bottle of ketchup that you might have paid $3 for, going shopping in your own little grocery store, because when the prices were better? This is the reason why. You know, I never meant to like talk about stockpiles in general on this channel. I'm talking about like on and off intermittently, maybe once or twice a month on this channel. I will discuss stockpiling. See the reason? $8 for a bottle of ketchup. So let's just say that a person bought two or three bottles of ketchup in better times because they know their family loves it and they enjoy it themselves, and they put it away in their stockpile. Doesn't it make a heck of a lot more sense? Now, the other option regarding the ketchup is, like I said, you could buy it, use a lot less, let it last longer. I think we overconsume. I mean, I could be wrong. I don't know. How's your opinion about that? Do you think that in general, people tend to overconsume? Because I could look back at times like back when I was growing up, and literally a cup of coffee. And I even did a video about this a long time ago, about 7-8 months back, about how even cups of coffee has changed. Like the idea of when somebody drank a cup of coffee at home. Right now, you guys are familiar with the big, big, big red cup that I always use. One of these days, I'm going to swap it out for my own cup that I actually have from my own store. Anyway, make a long story short, these cups today are so huge. You could put a meal, literally a meal in that cup. Not the case back in the old days. If you ever watch those old-timey classic TV shows from the 1950s and 60s, you're not going to see somebody sitting there with what looks like, in my opinion, a soup mug. You're not going to see that. People drank out of dainty little cups. Even just that tip alone, let's get back to frugality and a tip here. I think if we reduce or go, if you have some old, smaller size cups at home, you'll probably be saving yourself a small fortune every year without realizing it. Go back to those smaller sizes. We do not need 20-ounce mugs. Well, some people do. They say they do. Do we really need? Here's the question. Do you ask yourself? Only you can answer it. Ask yourself, do you really need to drink an 18 to 20 ounce size mug of coffee? Look back at those old TV shows. I cannot imagine Ward or June drinking out of the monster size cups that we have here at this time. Because the more you need, the bigger the cup, the more coffee you use, the more coffee you use, the more water you use, blah, blah, blah. I could go down the list. It's just, you know, it's like falling down a rabbit hole. All right. So we have to cope with our $8 bottles of ketchup in some locations. All right. We don't have to. We do have choices. This is why it pays to be frugal all the time. Not just pull a rabbit out of the hat during inflationary times. We have to use these methods all of the times, in better times. This is why I emphasize, if you get a product that is on sale on your next grocery haul that your family actually uses and likes, you can start, and you can store it, find out if it's shelf stable, if it's a canned item, and so on and so forth. Use that in your stockpile. So should the day come that that item goes up to a ridiculous number, you will already be ahead of the game. You know what I think? I think we should do more like this lady does. Have an amazing, fantastic day, everybody. Take good care now. Thank you.